Today we are talking about column chromatography. Everything we are doing should be done in a hood because we are using volatile organic solvents. For video purposes, we are doing it on the benchtop, but remember, always work in a hood. You are already familiar with the TLC, which is a separation technique that uses silica gel chromatography. TLC is an analytical technique, meaning that all you get out of this technique is information. You're using way too little compound for it to be practically useful. If you want to have a sizable amount of compound, you have to scale it up. So to scale it up, you don't use just a very thin layer of silica on a plastic backing, you use a lot of silica and you pack a column of it. Column chromatography is a very touchy technique. There are three phases in column chromatography. First, you pack the column, that is, you prepare it for your experiment. Then you load it, which is the equivalent of spotting the TLC plate, that is, you put your compound on the silica gel, and then you run it, which is the equivalent of putting your TLC plate in the TLC chamber and running it up. The only difference between TLC and the column chromatography is that in TLC, your solvent goes up by capillary action. In column chromatography, your solvent goes down by gravity, but that's the only difference. The columns we have here are actually very handy because the stopcock comes up. The very first thing you want to do is take a very small cotton plug and put it at the bottom of the column. And then you carefully reinsert the stopcock. This will prevent the sand from going down the stopcock. And then you want to clamp the column. You put a powder funnel on top and you put in sand. The silica gel column must be a perfect cylinder, so you want to put in enough sand to go past any curvature in the side of the column. The solvent that you are going to use in order to pack the column is the solvent that you will use to run the column. So it's going to be a mixture of hexane's ethyl acetate that you already determined by TLC. So you start by pouring a little bit of your mixture on top of the sand, and if you see, there's some air coming up. Then you tap the sides of the column to make sure the sand is perfectly flat. You will need approximately 14 grams of silica gel. Dry silica gel has a density of about 0.5, so there's no need to really weigh. It's going to be approximately 28 milliliters. So if you use a 30 milliliters beaker and you go somewhere in between 25 and 30 is plenty accurate. So that's what we are going to do. That's approximately the right amount. You transfer it into a bigger beaker and you want to make a slurry with your solvent. So you add enough solvent, oops, sorry, that's not a big deal. Then you add enough solvent to make a very runny slurry, fairly liquid. And you want to stir it very well. And then you need to pour it into the column while you are stirring to keep the gel in suspension. So you do this. And then you can add some more solvent to rinse the beaker. And it's not important that not all the silica gel is going into the column. This is totally inconsequential. Now you open the column and you let your solvent flow through. You are going to tap on the column with a plastic object to allow the silica gel to settle. It's important that the silica gel never goes dry. Now that you have run a column worth of solvent through the column, you want to close the stopcock and you need to repeat the operation. The solvent that ran through a column during packing is clean, so you can reuse it. It is extremely important not to disturb the surface of the silica gel when you are pouring the solvent. So at the very beginning, you can use a pipette and add solvent very slowly. And then when you have enough solvent to buffer the fall, you can add a little faster. You reopen the stopcock and you let all this solvent go through again. Make sure you stop before the surface of the silica gel, because it's very important that the silica gel never goes dry. To be able to watch the silica gel settling, it is actually helpful to mark the level of the silica gel with a Sharpie. And while the solvent is going through, you keep gently tapping the sides to help settling. In theory, you should keep running solvent through the column until the silica gel stops settling. When you have about 5 millimeters of solvent on the column head, you want to close the stopcock, and you need to add a little sand on the top of the column in order to protect the silica gel. And a couple of millimeters are enough. Like that. And then with a pipette, you may want to rinse the sides of the column. And let the solvent drain until the sand goes dry. And you want to stop right there. So the sand is dry, but the silica gel is not. At this point, your column is packed and is ready to be loaded. Now that you're ready to load your compound. In our case, the compound is a liquid, so it's very easy. You want to use a long Pasteur pipette and drop it right in the middle of the dry sand. And then you open the stopcock and you let the compound enter the column, which means you go with the sand dry. And you stop right there. Now you want to rinse the walls of the container in the Pasteur pipette that you used to load, so to make sure that all your compound is loaded. So you take a clean Pasteur pipette, you take about 1 ml of solvent, you put it in, and you wash the walls. And then you put this solution again at the top of the sand. Be careful not to disturb the surface of the silica gel when you do this. And then you open the stopcock and you let the solution enter your column. And you go again dry with the silica gel. At this point, your column is loaded and you can start running it. So you can add your eluting solvent very slowly at the beginning so you don't disturb the surface of the silica gel. And then more briskly, until the column is full. Now you're ready to run, so you can open the stopcock and you will start collecting small fractions in test tubes. And this concludes your column chromatography video.